be the top. But I want to do this.
I think horrible. That is egalitarian because she's a leader at home.
Egalitarian is 50-50 everything.
Right.
So voting on every type of issue that you have.
No.
Like, should we turn left right here?
So there's 100% of responsibilities and you uphold 50 of them, which is bread making. And then you come home and I break the bread.
Well, there's different types. We can't put values on it.
It's deeper than that. It's deeper than just you go to work. You're making sure if some shit go wrong at the house, you call a plumber or you fix it. And I'm cooking, I'm cleaning, I'm taking care of the kids. No, it's more. It gets down to like the logistics and dynamics of the relationship. Some shit I don't want to have to make a decision. I don't even want to think about it. I want my man to be able to take care of it. Mm-hmm. It could be anything,
yeah.
But I don't want to think about this shit. You do it.
Yeah,
change because the oil. I know that you have the ability take out the to trash. Like make a better decision.
Yeah, well you're sitting here getting really
at home stuff. It's so much deeper than at home stuff. Like you were saying, like you are listening. I feel like you're listening off just not stupid stuff, but like petty stuff in a sense. Like you just
surface
listen off
level.
Surface. Thank you, surface level things. But like when you in a real relationship, you do different things for your partner and vice versa. Like, yeah. It's not just the basics. If you want a real long-lasting relationship, it goes far beyond just surface-level shit.
Well, I like what I like to tell everybody is, like, how me and her are, we're constantly working for each other.
Yes.
So that means that if she it's always like, what do you need? 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 And she's always like, what do you need? What do you need? What do you need? It's to the point where we don't even have to ask what we need anymore. She already fucking knows what I'm always going to answer.
It's like they say, if you
it's a servant. You got to be a servant on both sides.
You don't know how to take care of a plant, then you don't know how to care for anything. Honestly, like, it's that simple because it's like a nurturing thing.
It's just being Christ-like. I don't even like being that religious on this channel, but it's being Christ. It's being giving and not giving without accepting something.
Exactly.
And everybody today is so fucked up because they have so much pride and they only will give if they get something in return. That is the worst. Transactional. Yes, it is the worst thing you can do in your life. And that's with every fucking relationship you have with your spouse, with your friends, with your family. You should always be giving. And the universe is a beautiful fucking thing, guys. Mm-hmm. It gives back when you give to it.
Yeah.
Every time. So it's just like, if once you find that guy, work hard for him. And if he reciprocates it, that means that's the one.
Y'all both trying to help each other win. It's no competition. Y'all both trying to better each other.
Teamwork makes the dream work.
For sure. What was the question, bro?
It was, have you ladies ever experienced or had burning genuine desire for a man? And
why did it
which
end?
It was. So why did it end?
Yeah. Why did? Did you answer it?
I feel like I had a genuine burning desire for the man that I'm currently with.
It's not ended.
It's
so
just
it's
been a thing all my life. I've been knowing him my whole life. So it's just been a thing. And I feel like I feel like he's worth a lot of shit. A lot of shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, he's a great person. Phenomenal.
He better be watching this. You hear her.
Yeah. Ring on it.
We're not gonna hide him on the story for this one. What about you?
I did have a guy that I was like all about, but I think I went dumb on it, you know, like, I felt like I gave too much at first. Yeah. Like, you know, you gave me, I give you, you know, we're taking care of each other. And like you said, like you remind me of him sometimes, like with all your, like, I'm a man, like I'm very traditional. Mm-hmm. And he was like that too. Like he had kids, he had younger kids. And, I stepped into that role of like stepmom and like potty training and like all this. We moved to another state together, like all of this. And he cheated on me. So it's like, I'm sitting here cooking and cleaning, like raising kids that aren't even mine. Like their mom wasn't even like in the picture, you know, like I was a down ass bitch, like since day one, you know? Yeah, and like for you to do me like this, it's just like,
I got to ask how tall was he? Was he really attractive?
No, he was 5'9", actually.
What was he really attractive, though?
I mean, to me, to me, he was.
To
the average woman,
But what does that have anything to do with integrity?
Well, because there's, and I'm not saying, like, so let me just say this beforehand. There's high-value men and there's high-quality men, okay? Mm-hmm. A high-value man is he's valuable. So that means other people see him as valuable too, not just you, okay?
Yes.
You were probably dating a guy that was a high value man. And I'm not saying he's a good quality man because he cheated. But you got to understand when y'all date or when women date high value men. And there's obviously, now there's a huge difference between a guy who sits there and he was on Tinder and all these dating apps while coming home to you, you know, like chasing all these girls all the time, and then he finally got some pussy from one of them or something and cheated on you. I think there's a difference between that type of guy, because he's a piece of shit. He's a fucking loser. He's a simp. He's giving out too many resources to other women. But the, like, let's say he was such a valuable guy that women throw themselves at him. It is extremely hard for not only for a guy to have that, but it's rare. Not most men can't do that. So if he exercised that option, I would just, you know, argue some men, like, I don't know, some, like, this is usually for the women, honestly, in the black community, because black men are extremely sought after. They're extremely fetishized because of pornography and because of rap music and stuff. So usually sometimes I have to give advice to some black women, like, your man is going to be, you know, like, he might exercise some options, you know, and you might, if you need to decide if you're the type of woman where you can be with that or not. And there's some women, though, who will do that. And that's why guys will do that, is because they will find a woman who will be okay with it sooner or later sometime. Absolutely. Not saying, not saying it's a good thing. Yeah, but no. It's just the times we live in. And you got to understand, though, this is something that if we look back at biology, we look at history, there's tons of men that did this. Alexander the Great, like sultans, like there's
Martin Luther King cheated.
Yeah, even Martin Luther King
cheated, baby.
So like it's King David. Like you gotta understand.
Like what?
Now I'm not saying any of it is good. If you read the Bible, all the men that did this stuff didn't exactly have the best lives because they did it. There was negative repercussions from it. So I don't preach for guys to do this, but I understand the world and how it is, and I understand that those men, this is one of those things, you know, I like to go back to biology, and I understand that there's certain men that do that. Yeah, y'all just don't choose them. Y'all choose the good, normal guys, and you're fine. But I also have to understand, just like how there's a percentage of men that do that, there's also women, there's a percentage of women that care a lot. They're biologically designed to look for a provider. So there's some women that we would call gold diggers, but they're not really gold diggers. They're biologically designed to look for a man that makes more than them. That is, yeah, and is a provider.
Smart.
Yeah.
But aren't we all programmed this way, but except we're conditioned otherwise?
Guys are not looking for providers ever. We're never looking for a woman.
Not us women being the provider. But think about it. If you are, I don't know what type of man you are.
But think about it.
I just don't know.
For example, I'm going to put it out there. Lala Anthony, right? She divorced Carmelo Anthony for cheating, right? And he had a baby, blah, blah, blah. What is her life like now?
She getting that body done.
But how she just out there flourishing, though.
She's doing a lot, but she looks lonely.
You know what she wants, though.
She wants attention.
Nobody still have not wiped her up yet.
She wants a companion.
She wants, she's dating this young guy from the BMF show. This thing. Think about the options we have once we fall in love. Think about the options we have once we fall in love with a man. And try to just go out again. Tierra Mori, the twin.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
She said, she just posted today, I hope love find me again.
Really? I'm so glad I don't be on Instagram.
She left, she think about why she left her marriage, because she wasn't happy. Think about the option that women have once they leave these relationships.
Can I say something?
We don't have options like that to find love. We have options to fuck. Yeah, that's easy.
Yeah. You don't think we said that before.
It's easy to go out and have sex with a man. Because at the end of the day, we're going to always compare that person that so-called cheated on us and did us wrong. We're going to still compare other people to the person that did us wrong. You ain't going to find nothing else.
If you had real burning, genuine desire for him, and you're alpha, like we were talking about alpha widowed is like whenever a guy was so good, like you're widowed by him. Like you can't even see other men. Because, like, that guy was so fucking baller, you know? Like, he was so good. And you can also be alpha widowed in categories. Like, women that sleep around a lot, you can have a guy that gave you such a badass experience on a vacation, a guy that has such good dick game, the best kisser, the best, like, you can be category. You can have so many things that are, like, way up here that every guy you meet is barely hitting half on any of those things. And it's just like, well, fuck, all these guys suck. And it's just like, well, yeah, you experience a lot of really awesome shit. And now you don't want to experience, like, your body. Women are extremely, y'all know that y'all's orgasm, how y'all are sexually, it is all very mental. It is very, like, emotional.
That's
and
why
shit.
The missionary girls, ooh, when you find you that one.
But yeah, but that's saying, but that's why you have to protect
it. So fast, and we use being bored or being this and that to leave a relationship. But sometimes you gotta really put yourself in the man's shoes. Like, what did you do to make them cheat? Like, sometimes we really, really have to look at this shit.
Sometimes,
not all the time.
I will say this.
action at all. Tasha to take responsibility for your poor actions.
You did what you had to do as like you was being a stepmom. You was doing all this.
So 1 Corinthians chapter. So 1 Corinthians chapter 6 talks about this in the Bible, and it says that a man is supposed to always serve his, like, if his woman is asking for sex, he's supposed to give it to her.
Ooh,
if his,
on if, the man,
if,
Poppy.
If the man is asking for sex, she has to give it to him. Like, it literally says that. And the only time that you're supposed to take breaks is when y'all have a scheduled time for prayer. Like, that's literally what the verse says. And the reason why it says that is because for a healthy relationship, like, y'all understand a lot of stuff in the Bible may be dated, but it is actually good advice because people have been doing relationships for thousands of years. Mm-hmm. It's actually, some of it is actually really solid advice to keep a relationship together. And a lot of men leave for what she's saying. Like, the woman is withholding sex. She's mad about something. Or you got to understand, if guys are usually leaving or if they're like seeking it out, it's usually because something's going on. There's some type of thing, you know, going on. But I mean, then there's some guys that they're just such G's, like I'm saying. They have girls throwing themselves at them.
Right. And like in your situation, like you didn't have kids with him, right? Mm-mm. And you doing all these things and this and that, you kind of devalue yourself to the point where you felt like you probably feel sorry for him. A lot of women, we be feeling sorry for men. These mama boys, these men that sell you these stories that they family didn't do nothing in their life. They mama want shit. They daddy want shit. So all of a sudden, we become mothers to men that's supposed to already be at that point. You want a provider. Yeah. A man can't be a provider if he come to you and send you these sad ass stories. So now you feel like, and I'm not trying to mean. He need me. So now you feel like he needed you. He probably told you these stories about his baby mama. He told you a story about his baby mama. His baby mama won shit, and now he got these kids, so you feel like, he need me to survive.
I love those kids.
At the end of the day, that man's supposed to be the head. Mm-hmm. If he ain't trying to be the head, baby, it's time to go.
So I have a question. I know y'all, what about the man who just can't control themselves? Because y'all touched on the men who are just high value and sought after, you know, and y'all touched on the man who is like just a good man, you know.
Yeah, the high quality man, yeah.
And so what about the man who just can't control themselves?
That is a high value. If
we were talking about sexual preferences, if the man is not getting it at home, then he's seeking it out. But it's like, what about the man who just can't control it? What if he is
like he's such an animal? He has to just always fuck other girls. It's come so easy to him. See, I don't, and to me, that's giving out reason. I don't like a guy that's chasing pussy, like in any way, shape, or form. I believe in holding your frame, and the right women will come into your frame.
That's a king.
But like a lot of men though, they're like animals. They want to fuck more, and it's probably because it comes easy to him. You got to, once again, it's really hard for men to get sex. 33% of men from the ages of 18 to 30 are virgins and/or haven't had sex this year. So most men, 1/3 of men, aren't fucking right now, and that's it. So the guys that are fucking, they're really fucking small. Like, that's a small percentage of men that are doing really fucking good and getting a lot of girls and shit. So I think that when a guy gets into a habit because it's easy for him, like it's easy for him to slide into DMs and the girl always responds, or he has really good pictures or whatever, he's attractive, I don't think you can stop it. Like, it's a habit that he's built over years, and it's not going to stop. And like, I always say it's damaging because the trauma that you see whenever you're doing that as a guy. So a lot of guys that do that, they're fucking other guys' wives or other people's girlfriends, and they're like seeing that shit, they're like, oh, I'll never trust a fucking woman, like I'll never fucking do any of this shit. And it's kind of traumatizing. So like me personally, like I experienced it, and I don't think it makes me scared of relationships now because of the things I've seen in the past. And so it's just like, I don't think it's a good thing. So I think if you have a guy like that, you should avoid them. And to me, it's simping. If a guy is liking girls' pictures, DMing them, chasing them, it's a simp thing to me.
It's